64 identical mercury drops, each of capacity 1 microfarad, form a big drop. Calculate the capacity of the bigger drop. Here small drops are combining to form the big drop. Here once the small drops combine, we know that the radius of the bigger drop is equal to n to the power of 1/3 into radius of the small drop. Assuming volume of the big drop is n times the volume of a single drop. Charge on the big drop is equal to n times the charge on the small drop. Now, in the case of spherical drops, mercury drops or whatever you take, we know that capacity is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught into r. There is no dependence on charge. So, capacity of the big drop by capacity of the small drop is radius of the big drop by radius of the small drop, which is nothing but n to the power of 1/3. So, capacity of the big drop is always n to the power of 1/3 into capacity of the small drop. Now here, n is given as 64 and Cs is 1 microfarad. So, 64 whole to the power of 1 by 3 into 1. 64 whole to the power of 1 by 3. This can be taken as 4 cube into 1. That cube and 3 gets cancelled. 1 by 3, 3. So, remaining 4. So, answer is 4 microfarad. The capacity of the big drop once they combine to form the big drop. So liquid drops combine, whether it is potential, energies, etc. We are interested relation between the radii of the big drop and the radius of the small drop. This relation is derived basing on the total volume of the big drop is equal to n times the volumes of the small drop because n drops combine. If I imagine n drops combine, then VB is n into VS. From this we can prove this one. QB is n into QS, but in case of capacity, no use with this charge. Substitution gives us capacity of the big drop is n to the power of 1/3 into capacity of the small drop.